Hello, my name is Prophetess Janelle, and I am here to release another word to you on today. If this is your first time joining with us on the Voice of the Prophet YouTube channel, thank you for coming. And if you're a returning subscriber or visitor, I'm also welcoming you back and thanking you for joining us as well. And so I just want to really get right into it on today and release what the Lord has put on my heart. For, I would say, the past month or so, the Lord has really been burdening me with His church, allowing me to feel His heart, His compassion that He has towards His bride. And He told me this, as I was praying one day, He told me, He said, I'm coming to feed you, I'm coming to feed you. He's coming to feed His people. He sees the condition and the state that they are in. And I want to read this Bible verse, and it's coming from Isaiah 27, verse 2 through 3. In that day, sing about the fruitful vineyard. I, the Lord, will watch over it, watering it carefully. Day and night, I will watch so no one can harm it. And this was a scripture the Lord gave me. He allowed me to really hone in on for a majority in the beginning of the pandemic and everything that was arising, and the words of comfort that He brought to me during that time about how even in the midst of chaos and storms that He protects His people, that He keeps us, and even in the midst of a storm that He is the one who brings peace. And so many, He began to speak to me and put into my heart where many of the people in the body of Christ had become very weak. They have become very weak in their faith, in their spirit, you know, in their relationship with God. Many have gone astray. Many just feel weary from the trials that they face, the things that have happened, you know, the loss of life, loss of loved ones, you know, the places of everything is changing and shifting, where this pandemic has come and kind of knocked a lot of people off their feet. Changes happen with people's schooling, job situations. People lost their jobs. Financial situations were put into chaos. There was just so much that has happened. You know, family dynamics have changed. And in the midst of just a year, the whole world has been turned upside down. And even though the Lord has a plan, and the Lord has, you know, He has a plan, He has a purpose, and the things that the Lord does, you know, is very strange the way He does it. The Bible says the strange acts. I believe Isaiah talks about the strange acts that the Lord does. But even in the midst of us, God is considerate about His people. He sees His bride. He sees the condition that it is in. He sees the hurting ones. He sees the sorrowful ones. He sees the weak ones, the ones that feel as though they've been getting throw after throw. You know, they've been getting hit after hit, and they feel as though they cannot recover. Many of you feel as though you have not recovered, and there's just one thing happening after another, and you feel as though you just cannot get back up. You've been thrown a blow, and you see it. You feel as though your prayer life is not where it used to be. Your word is not where it used to be. And this is even for, you know, people who've been in the walk for a long time. You know, some things may happen and it really can just knock you off of your feet. But the Lord said He is coming for His people. Just like in the scripture in Isaiah, He said He is watching over that vineyard. You are a part of that vineyard. He's watching over that bride. And there are many people that are still maybe being able to maintain that place. But it's, you feel as though like you're in an autopilot, like you're just doing, you know, you're still going to church, maybe virtually, maybe in public. You know, you're still praying. You're still reading your word, but that fire that was there, that depth you had that was there, that faith you had that was there, that hope that you used to have, you don't really have that same space anymore because of everything that is still happening. You're still doing, you're still moving, but really the mental capacity in you is drained. You're spiritually dry, if that's the word I could say. And many people are in this space of being mentally drained and spiritually dry. And if that is you, then I'm talking to you on today. And He says to His bride, I'm concerned about her, and I see her, and I know the condition that she is in, and I am here to feed her. I am here to restore her. And the Lord reminded me of even the children of Israel. You know, they went through their little phases of seeing God manifest, but they still were very, you know, rebellious. And even in the place where He brought them out, where He brought them out of Egypt and He brought them to the wilderness. Watch this. In the wilderness, you know, was a very dry place. It was a desert place. But it was a place where God, even though it was a desert place, it was a perfect condition for God to show up and do miraculous works, even in the midst of their situation. There were times when they were hungry because, you know, the land wasn't plenteous in the wilderness place. There were times when they were thirsty, you know, because there was no rivers flowing in the wilderness. But even in those places, God God provided water for them. He provided manna that rained down. He provided quails that come from the sea to feed them. And the Lord is speaking over his people. You may feel as though you're in a wilderness place. You may feel as though that the land that you're in right now is very dry. But he wants to remind you that even in that place, it's a perfect condition and a situation for him to come and work a miracle in your life. God has not forgotten about you. He's not angry at you because of the things that have happened in your life. He's not angry because you've lost faith and you've lost hope. He's not angry because you become because you become mentally strained and stressed, and you have, watch this, you come in a place of, you feel as though you are in autopilot. You're just going. He's not upset. God is a restorer, and he is here to restore you. He knows that you're human. He knows that we all come into these places where we fall down, and he's here to help us to get back up again. He wants us to live. Just like Ezekiel, he said he's speaking life over those dry bones. God is coming to restore and feed his people. It may look different. It may not look the same to everybody. The encounter that you may have, the experience that you may have, that God will come to visit you and to bring water to you and to restore that place and to heal you. It may look different than your neighbors. But God has said he is concerned about his bride, and he is coming to feed them. He is coming to restore them. That was the cankerworm and the palmer worm came. He is restoring. He will restore what disappointment tried to steal. He is bringing back the water into your prayer life, the fervency into your prayer life. He is bringing the strength back into your faith. It is God. He said he will never leave you. He will never forsake you. He said, don't get weary in well-doing. Don't get weary in well-doing. These will be times of refreshing for his bride. These will be time of great restoration for his bride. This will be a time of a great spiritual inner healing for his bride. Even that of the mind, for many has been strained in the mind. Anxiety, depression, fear, hopelessness have come to try to steal your joy. But God said he is coming to restore you back. Do not lose hope. The God we serve is faithful. He is faithful and he is just. He is a father. And not only is he a father that provides, but he is a husbandman that cares and loves you. You are his bride. You are his children. And he said he is coming back to restore you. He's coming back to heal every one of those wounds. So don't allow what happened to you. Don't allow the loss of a loved one. Don't allow, you know, sickness, disease, loss of job, financial situations, changing in family dynamics. Don't allow that to come and steal that which you know you have on the inside of you. God loves you. He sees you. He cares and he is concerned. And I'm just so glad to be able to deliver this word to you, that God said he's coming to feed his people. You are his vineyard. He's watching over it. You may feel like as though you've been abandoned. You may feel as though the Lord has forgotten you. You may feel as though your prayers are not being answered. But God says no. God says no. As far as I can see in the Bible, God has never abandoned his people. He said he's watching over it day and night. Day and night. It may take some time for you to get back where you were, but he's coming to do it. He's watching over it day and night. He's not going to allow anything to come and steal and snatch. Though the enemy will try. He will even try to come, but he won't allow. No weapon formed against you will prosper. And that is God's word over your life. So people of God, be blessed. Be blessed, be blessed, be encouraged, stay hopeful, stay in the place of joy and thanksgiving before the Lord, because that which you've lost, God is so able to restore it. He came and he got you. He brought you into his salvation once. If he did it before, he can surely do it again. He can bring you back to the place where you feel like you've fallen from. So be blessed. And if you feel as though you want to share this video to encourage another person, I would just, I would encourage you to do so. And I'll be thankful for you doing that as well. Again, be blessed, and I will see you guys next time.